Good morning, guys. I hope y'all are having a blessed morning. I just want to holler at y'all and chit chat for just a quick moment while your girl waiting on a cup of coffee from, you already know, Starbucks. There's a very familiar text that I have read over and over, but I think I overlooked one particular part. We know about the story of Moses, the children of Israel, and how God used Moses to free the children of Israel from the captivity of their Egyptian dictator. Just to give you a little history behind it, the Pharaoh didn't want the children of Israelites to worship God. They were against God. The Egyptians were against God. They wanted to have the children of Israelites to remain inferior, to remain subservient to them. And so when it was time for the children of Israel to have their deliverance and for them to go and receive their own promise, Pharaoh came against God. He wanted smoke with God. So he thought. And for those of you who don't know what smoke means, it's an ethnic colloquialism that means he wanted to wage war. He wanted to fight. So he thought he wanted smoke with God, but when God started sending him plagues, he started crying like a little baby. I'm telling you, but he was wicked, and God turned his heart. He made his heart hard, so it wasn't a surprise or a shock that the Pharaoh kept trying to wage war against God, because God had already told Moses, I'm going to make his heart hard. But the part that I really want to key in on, y'all, is I think it's around Exodus 13, verse 17 is where it starts. But if I got it wrong, I'll definitely post it up top. The Bible says that by the time that Pharaoh let the children of Israel go, God did not allow them to go through the Philistine land, which was the shortest route to their promise, to the promised land, right? He did not allow them to go the short route. He caused them and he guided them to go the long way, because the Bible says had they went through the Philistine route, if they would have gotten to some sort of war, if they would have gotten to some sort of battle with them, they probably would have turned back to the Egyptian slavery. They probably would have ran and went back to the Egyptian bondage. I want you to know that there are some seasons in your life that God releases you from a thing and you feel like, God, why do I have to go through the wilderness? I already went through this slavery. I already went through this bondage. Why am I going through the wilderness? You promised me a promise. You told me that it was time for my breakthrough. You said that if I'm released from this particular place, or when you deliver me, or when you heal me from this particular thing, then I have something else to seize. But you taking me in the wilderness, I want you to know, the long way is for your protection. The long way sometimes is so that we don't go back into bondage. We learn in the wilderness. We grow in the wilderness. We metamorphosis in the wilderness. We transform in the wilderness. And so they couldn't go the shortest route, because it could have possibly led into some sort of war that would have caused them to fear and go back. See, sometimes the wilderness is a process. It processes out the mindset, the thought process, the things that you accepted when you were in bondage, the things that I accepted when I was in bondage. Sometimes the wilderness will cause you to learn who you really are. Sometimes that's the opportune time where God wants to pour back into you and cause you to recover emotionally and spiritually from the trauma that you already faced. That's why the wilderness is necessary. And so sometimes we'll say, God dang, you're taking me the long way. God dang, dang, D-A-N-G, you're taking me the long way, and I feel like I'm not gonna ever get to my promise. I want you to know that there's a promised land for you. If God brought you out, he's going to finish the work that he started. Just know that he can't take you the shortest route sometimes. Sometimes we're not ready to seize that thing. Sometimes we're not ready to go into that new relationship. Sometimes we're not ready for marriage. Sometimes we're not ready to have a child. Sometimes we're not ready to own a business. Sometimes we're not ready to do some certain things. Sometimes God got to take us through the wilderness to prepare us for the promise. And I promise you that the promise is not something you really have to work for, because that was already a land that was cultivated. It already had milk and honey. The thing that God wants to shift you in is not something you're gonna have to work for, but the wilderness is preparing you for that mindset. See, could it be that the children of Israelites were so used to working hard, what by the sweat of their brow, so used to being inferior, so used to being the minority, that had they seized the promise at that time, they still would have had that slave mindset? Sometimes it's a mentality mentality thing. Sometimes God can't shift us because our mentality haven't shifted. We still a slave to the enemy. We still a slave to the devices and the tricks and the traps of the enemy. And God is saying, that's not who you are. You are my child. And what I give you is yours to seize. And so sometimes that wilderness is simply to grow us. It's to mature us. It's to prepare us. It's to free us so that when we get to the promise, we can enjoy it. So that when we get to the promise, we don't think we got to go in and say, yes, sir, master, I'm ready to till this land. No, God is saying, I'll give you land that you didn't till. I'll give you houses that you didn't build. I own the cattle on the thousand. God said he owns everything, and there's no good thing that he will withhold from you, but I want you to know you had to go the long way. The long way was good. Thank God for the wilderness. Thank God for the darkness. Thank God for the trials. Thank God. I thank him because I remember times, like seasons of my life, when I faced one of the most traumatic seasons of my life, I was wondering, God, why do I have to go through this? Why is it that it's taking so long? But man, looking back over that thing, and I know I'm not exactly where I want to be, but I'm surely not where I used to be. I'm saying, thank you, God, that you didn't give it to me. Thank you that you didn't give me a platform then. Thank you, Lord God, that you didn't give me a whole bunch of friends then. Thank you, Lord, that you didn't let me win the grant then. Thank you, Lord, that you didn't give me a business that I probably would have misused or mishandled because of my mindset. See, sometimes the long way is the necessary way, but I promise you there's a promise waiting for you. And so don't be discouraged and don't be dismayed. Just know God is with you and he is for you. And if he is with you, who can be against you? Who? But you gotta allow that process to take its place in your life. Process is a journey to purpose. Process is necessary for purpose. So just know God loved you the long way. If he taking you the long way, he'll love you the long way.